There are structures in music other than periods. Smushing two phrases together does not always result in a period. There are specific criteria that have to be met in order for two phrases to create a period. Another common structure in music that is often of equal length to a period is called a sentence. A sentence is a musical structure that begins with the presentation and repetition of a basic idea and ends with a continuation that leads to a cadence. Here is an example. A sentence is generally 8 measures long. The basic idea is generally 2 measures long and frequently contains one or several distinct motives. The basic idea is then repeated, although normally at a different pitch level. The initial statement and repetition of the basic idea is known as the presentation. The harmony of the presentation is generally static, emphasizing tonic. A continuation follows the presentation and is generally 4 measures long. The goal of the continuation is to fragment the basic idea and to end with either an authentic or half cadence. When a basic idea is fragmented, the length of its parts are shortened by using smaller motivic bits from the initial idea, presented in varied repetitions or sequence. We'll discuss what a sequence is shortly. The continuation will also have an increase in harmonic rhythm. Harmonic rhythm is the rate of change of the harmonies. In the continuation, this rate of change will increase. The 3 parts of the sentence, the basic idea, the repetition of the basic idea, and the continuation, are normally in the proportions of 1 to 1 to 2, or multiples thereof. If we multiply each of these numbers by 2, we get a ratio of 2 to 2 to 4, which gives us the most common 8-measure sentence structure. A simple way to create interest and length in a phrase is to repeat the material. But simply repeating a motive or phrase at the exact same pitch level is repetitive and boring. Instead, composers use a composition device called sequence. A sequence is the restatement of a motive or a longer melodic or harmonic passage at a higher or lower pitch in the same voice. A sequence can be melodic, harmonic, or a combination of both. Let's look at an example. This example contains both a melodic and a harmonic sequence. Let's examine the melody first. A sequence contains an initial statement called the model, and at least 2 copies of the initial statement. In this example, each copy is stated a third lower. Melodic sequences can be real, which means that the intervals between each pitch in the model and the following copies are exactly the same. Or they can be tonal, meaning that the intervals between each pitch in the model and the subsequent copies are only generically the same in order to conform to the current key signature. In this example, a tonal sequence is used in the melody with 1 model and 2 copies. Let's turn our attention to harmonic sequences. There are 4 general patterns used in harmonic sequence. In a descending fifth sequence, the root of the chords descend by the interval of a fifth. While it's named after the descending interval of its root, the roots on the staff will not physically always descend. If they did, we'd run out of room on the staff or be out of an instrument's or vocalist's range pretty quickly. To keep the sequence in a comfortable range, the roots will actually descend by fifth and then ascend by fourth, which is just an inverted fifth. An ascending fifth sequence is just like the descending fifth sequence, but with roots that ascend by fifth. Again, the fifth is inverted to a fourth on every other chord to keep the chord progression in a good range. In a descending third sequence, a descending stepwise bass line is created through the alternation of root position and first inversion chords. The motion by descending third occurs on every other chord. The intervening first inversion chords are not required, but they create a fluid stepwise descent. The ascending 5-6 sequence also contains alternating root position and first inversion chords, but this time they are used to create a stepwise ascending bass line. The 5-6 label refers to two things: the alternation of root position 5-3 chords and first inversion 6-3 chords, and the upper voice motion from a fifth above the bass to a sixth above the bass. Note that each type of harmonic sequence contains at least one model and two copies. Also note that the pattern established in the right hand in the model is then replicated in the copies. Let's return to our example. We know that the melody contains a tonal sequence with one model and two copies. Let's look at the accompanying harmonic sequence. The Roman numeral analysis shows alternating root position and first inversion triads. The bass line is descending by step. So this is an example of a descending third sequence. Sequences often function to prolong a harmony. The prolonged harmony will begin and end the sequence. Notice that here the one chord begins and ends the sequence. In deeper hierarchical levels, we would show this prolongation and then the motion towards the half cadence. As mentioned earlier, the continuation of a sentence often contains fragmentation and sequence. As we'll see in the next module, sequence and other compositional techniques can help a composer expand the length of a musical structure, such as a period or a sentence.